And there's a very real movement today that's been wonderfully successful in the sense of accomplishing its aims, and that is to flens physical culture of the coordination, accuracy, agility, and balance components. These four pieces here. I'll come back to that more specifically in a minute. But what we have is a current milieu where the more nuanced and technical pieces of training are left out. Now, as simple as the squat is, as simple as the deadlift is, they need instructing, correct, gentlemen? They need to be instructed. In the clean, you won't find significant success without a little help along the way. And the snatch, this is true of pull-ups. Even a bench press, as simple as that move is, and it's relative to, say, a snatch, it is, you could agree, it's a pretty simple movement. You sit and listen to Mark Ripito for an hour on this thing and slide under the bar, and you're all of a sudden stronger. All of a sudden stronger, which brings up a very important question, and the question is more important in the answering than the asking, and that is, what is strength? Now, if strength is for you, for someone you know, like a physical therapist or someone out of the bodybuilding community, if strength is contractile potential, so all I want to do is you know, hook electrodes up and go and, you know, work against that and see what the contractile potential is, use electromyogram to measure the ability of the nerves to innervate the fiber and get them to shorten. If contractile potential is your definition of strength, so be it, I'll take it. But that's not where we're going here. It's not what we're looking for. For us, and this is another one that's worth writing down, I'm gonna go to board for it. Strength is productive application of force. I don't care about contractile potential any more than I care about VO2 max. It's a correlate. Believe it, isn't that a trippy thing? Contractile potential is a correlate. Does it correlate to strength? Yes. Does it correlate to productive application of force? Yes. But what is it that we add to contractile potential to make it productive? And productive would mean what? Able to complete
work.
Yes, and specifically, ideally, what? Functional movements, because they have the greatest potential for work by just their fundamental characteristic, large loads, long distance, and quickly. So power, work capacity. What do I need to add to contractile potential to maximize the work capacity of the individual?
Neuromuscular?
Yes, exactly right. It's technique. I teach you how to deadlift on Monday. We find out what your max is. I don't recommend do that, but I have. Find a max. Write it down. Come back 3 days later. It'll be bigger. And you'll be profoundly sore from the effort, and it'll still be higher. What happened? Did we increase contractile potential? I promise you not. It's neurological. Let's look to this list again. So I've got coordination, accuracy, agility, and balance. These are neurological adaptations. They come about through practice. And these four are organic. They come about through training. They're enhanced by training, enhanced by practice, and power and speed are equal parts from both camps. We have fully embraced a fitness culture, not you CrossFitters, the rest of the world, have fully embraced a fitness culture that has held in the lowest of regards coordination, accuracy, agility, and balance. And I'm not talking about trying to teach the Marine Corps how to do standing back flips or how to get football players to walk on their hands. I'm talking about trying to get just normal people in PE class in our everyday training, certainly in sports training, but maybe less so, to undertake movements that have a coordination, accuracy, agility, and balance component to them. So that we have tried to bring some of these movements like the clean and the overhead squat into certain communities, and we've just been told outright, inappropriate, not here. What are the reasons for that? Well, I've heard that soldiers aren't smart enough for the snatch. I've heard that the clean is dangerous for middle school kids. I've been told that the Los Angeles Police Department doesn't have enough time to teach people how to squat. The excuses are just endless. Now let me speak to the, and if you wanted to define this program, so I can tell you on one level it's you can look at it as prescription, right? It's constantly varied functional movements executed at high intensity. Or you can talk to the adaptation and say that what I did in my second lecture here, just regurgitate that it's about increasing work capacity across broad time and modal domains. Well, it's also about working with some funky movements. I mean, in the most macro kind of sense, people will identify this program looking outside the gym, looking in. Because they're over there doing this shit, right, at Globo Gym, and they look in here and look, there's like nets in the roof and shit. Yeah, they actually like climb. And so we can be defined by the movements alone. You see a single picture. Was anyone fooled by the 300 movie when you saw the workout? I mean, you can hear Mark Twight talk, and you look in the background and they're doing Fran, right? I mean, you know what that is. We recognize and we see it. We've somewhat branded human movement. What is it that we're doing that is so different? It is that we have deliberately engaged in movements that require some technique, and I'm here to talk to you about why. The why of that. Is it because I got a lot of time on my hands and I was a gymnast and I like cute little movements in slippers with your toes pointed? Is that it?
Yeah.
Yeah. You weren't supposed to tell them. No, it's because the payoff is worth it. The payoff is worth it. Now, look, we deliberately flens coordination, accuracy, agility, and balance. And I'm not talking about removing the gymnastics components, even though I keep hearing that guys 6 feet tall, 200 pounds, can't do gymnastics. I introduce them to Eddie Lugo. They're like, oh shit, okay, let me come up with another excuse. And by the way, the dangerous is a wild red herring, entirely unsubstantiable. Not unsubstantiated, unsubstantiable. There are reasons for engaging in these movements that have nothing to do with anything other than safety. If I can justify the inclusion of the movements we include for safety alone. So we flens balance, agility, accuracy, coordination, and immediately power and speed take a hit. Why? Yeah, they're built from it. Yes. They're half neurological, at least. Let's look at strength. If strength is productive application of force, will you develop maximum strength without technique? If it's contractile potential, possibly. It may be, if contractile potential, if we accept that as a definition of strength, then maybe bodybuilding is the way to go. You don't really practice that. Now, hook me up. Yeah, look while I'm doing it. But we're not looking for that. I need to move body or external object from some point A to point B efficiently and effectively. I want power. I want to move large loads, long distance, and quickly. And what we know is that the key, the thing that connects functionality to the maximum expression of power, that is intensity up. The key is technique. If you buy into this notion that strength is a productive application of force, you can set up instance after instance after instance where simple technique makes the difference between success or failure. I can't think of many movements that could make a difference in winning game, protecting your life, or completing your mission, that when it comes down to it, those movements are better off taught than not. How simple is can stand? And yet, are you able to all get thank you and down? Simple enough, doesn't need to be trained, does he? If he's my client, yes, he does. How do we figure that out? Well, I train him with the air squat. Looks good, let's go overhead. Looks good, let's get some numbers. Looks good, let's put some load up there. Looks good, let's add some more. At some point it won't look good. What do we come back to when that happens? Every time, fundamentals, right? We don't find it like he was, at 200 kilos he looked great, at 215 he had a problem and we had to address something that is entirely unrelated to the fundamentals of the squat. It's never like that. It's never like that. Always back to basics, always back to basics. Let me share with you some other aspects of this. Flexibility. I can come into an environment of athletes over and over and over again and tell them, you got to get more flexible. You need to be more flexible. You need greater flexibility. and I can bring in a strength, a stretching coach, and I can sentence you to yoga classes. There's a lot of things we can do. And it turns out that fundamentally what the bulk of you will do it, and especially in a community like this one, is ignore it. Ignore it. But if I can instill within a community, and this I can do readily, where the overhead squat and kipping pull-ups and say, pick something else, the muscle up, have intrinsic, inherent, local value, and then what happens, every time I step back into the community, I find that people are more and more flexible. Follow the theme here. What would flexibility be for us? Is it just range of motion? And I'll give you the example of strength is more than contractile potential, it's productive application of force. Flexibility would then be what?
Protect.
Range of motion adequate to?
Productive application of force.
Yeah.
Large range of motion.
Yeah, or functional movement.
Go.
Right.
He said it.
You're getting it, aren't you? And so look, a guy says, I don't know about flexibility, but I have perfectly adequate range of motion for snatch, squat, dead, front squat, kipping pull-ups, muscle-ups, and give me the whole list of all our primary players. Do you need more range of motion for anything other than that? I'm going to tell you, other than bedroom exploits, no. You're solid.